Hallelujah and praise the name of the Lord. This day and this hour, I want to call our attention to the book of Luke, chapter number 19 and verse number 13. That's where we are going to get our reading that the Lord has called us to hear from. Can you give me the King James Version? King James Version of the text. Thank you. If we don't have it, let us just read the version that we have. This is what the Bible says, if we can read together. And so, he called 10 of his servants, delivered to them 10 minas, and said to them, do business till I come. The other version of the King James Version says, so he called 10 of his servants, delivered 10 to them, the 10 minas, and said to them, occupy till I come. Hallelujah. That's the topic of my word today. Occupy till I come. That's what God is calling us to do. To occupy until that time when he comes. Take dominion until that time when he comes back. Be in charge and in control until he comes back. God is calling his church today that we may occupy until he comes. Not to give chance to anybody else. Not to give room to anything else. Not to delay and to complain. Not to murmur and not to do anything. God is calling his church to occupy until he comes. Amen. People and children of God, when you read and you follow the scripture and the word of the Lord, if you look closely into the Bible, in the book of the same writer and author, Luke chapter number 10, 25 to 37, Jesus is ministering and Jesus is teaching with his disciples. And when Jesus was teaching with his disciples, the Bible tells me that one expert of the law of the Moses came unto Jesus and asked Jesus, Master, what can I do so that I may have eternal life? This expert of the law wanted to understand the qualification for one to have eternity, the qualification for one to enter into the kingdom of God. The master and the expert of the law wanted to understand how he can qualify that he may have eternity and share the kingdom with Jesus. But then Jesus, the Bible tells me that Jesus looked at him and told him, have you read the scripture? And what do they say if you have read the scripture? Then the expert continues to say, yes, I've read the scripture. And the Bible that I read has told me that I should acknowledge Jesus and God as the only God that I have. The second thing that I understand is I've been cautioned to love my neighbor as I love myself. And then Jesus looked at this expert on law and told him, yes, you are right. That is what we are called to do, to recognize the absolute power of God and also to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. Hallelujah. And Jesus continues to elaborate and to give a parable unto this expert on the law so that he can understand what it means by the scripture and the word of God. And therefore we are given the story and the parable of the good Samaritan. When you read that story very well, you realize that the Bible says someone was bruised, somebody was hurt, but so many people who came across to him, they could not help him. They did not pay attention. They did not do anything to him. They were just passing near to him and he did nothing. But one man stood exceptional. He is called the Good Samaritan. That this man, when he came across the hurt man, he said, I cannot leave this man. I'm going to carry him to somewhere where he can be saved. I'm going to a certain point. I want someone to listen to me carefully. When the Good Samaritan took this man who was hurt by thugs, he took him to a hotel. And the Bible says, when the Good Samaritan took this man to a hotel, it says that he paid for the expenses that this man was supposed to cater for, that this man was supposed to be taken care of by the owner of the hotel. Hallelujah. When this man was hurt, was taken to the hotel or place where he was supposed to be nursed, the Good Samaritan paid every expense, paid for every penny that was required that this man may be taken care of. And the Bible continues to say that the Good Samaritan said unto the owner of the hotel, if this water paid unto you gets exhausted, once I come back unto this place, I'm going to pay for every other coin that this man has spent. Hallelujah. People and children of God, many are the times that we read the Bible amiss. We read the Bible halfway. We don't understand the content and the context of the scripture. I want somebody to understand something. That the Good Samaritan, when he paid, one thing that he understood is that for however long this man is going to be in this place being nursed, whatever he paid, he cannot exhaust. Hallelujah. The Good Samaritan understood the cost that I paid unto the owner of this hotel. However long this man is going to stay in this hotel, he cannot exhaust. He cannot finish. And he promised, once I come back, I'm going to pay for any other extra coin that this man has used in this facility of yours. But get me clear, people and children of God. If you read the Bible carefully, you can never notice anywhere where this Good Samaritan came back to pay anything. My soma Biblia vizuri. The Good Samaritan never came back to that hotel. Why? Because for one, he understood that he has paid for anything, for everything that will be required for this man to be there for as long as he's going to be there. So what was happening? That this man was hurt when he was taken out of that facility. If you look carefully, you are going to understand that he never came out. That he went to take dominion. That he went to take position. That he went to occupy. And up to now, he has never left that facility because the master has never came back. Hallelujah. The master has not yet come back. So he cannot leave the facility because he doesn't know whether he has a debt. Until the master, the Good Samaritan, comes back, that's when he will leave the facility. Hallelujah. People and children of God, we have been called by our Lord Jesus Christ to take charge and to occupy. Until he has come back, we have not been called to run away from charge. We have not been called away to run from the ministry. We are going to occupy until that time he is going to come. Until he comes, we are going to stay put. We are going to stay in position. We are going to stay in responsibility. We are going to occupy until he comes back. Hallelujah. Has your master come back? Has our master come back? Has Jesus come back? If he has not come back, then we don't have an authority to live where he left us, to occupy, to dominate, and to rule. I don't know whether somebody understands my point. Hallelujah. Occupy until I come. Do this business until I'm back. Do what I've called you to do until I come back. Hallelujah. So until he has come back, we are being called as children and sons and daughters of the kingdom. We are being called as servants of the Lord. We are being called as church to take position, to take dominion, to be responsible until our master comes back. Until he comes, we are not going to walk away. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. The good Samaritan left the guy in the facility and he went. He has never come back because the Bible has never told us so. So the man was hurt, is still waiting until the master, the good Samaritan, comes back. Hallelujah. People and children of God, what am I trying to say in this service? What I'm trying to say is that God has entrusted his church with every resources that is required. That God has trusted the church with every arsenal that is required. God has entrusted the church with every political arsenal that is required. God has entrusted the church with the economic arsenals which are required. God has empowered the church with every social responsibility that is required. God has empowered the church and has given us authority over everything. Until he comes back, the church is in charge and in control. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Until our master comes back, we as church, because the church is me and you, we are going to stay put. We are going to stay in control. We have been called to stay in our position until when he comes. It is the responsibility of the church to provide social guidance until he comes back. It is the responsibility of the church to provide political guidance until he comes back. It is the responsibility of the church to provide economic guidance, because he has put us that you should occupy until when I'm back. Hallelujah. People and children of God, if you read carefully, also in the same book, in the book of Luke chapter number 15, you realize where the problem came in. And Jesus gives us another parable of a woman who had 10 coins, but one coin get lost. And when the one coin get lost, the woman could not go anywhere until he finds that one coin. Remember, she has 10 coins. Only one 10 coin has been lost, but she cannot go anywhere until she finds it. What am I trying to say? What I'm saying is this, that God who has provided unto his child, we are so much committed unto our things that we are forgetting what we have been called to do. Hallelujah. Wakati huyu mama anapoteza pesa zake, huyu mama hakuwa kanisani. Alikuwa nyumbani kwake. Pesa zilipotelea kwake nyumbani. Na akaamua lazima zitafute mpaka hiyo senti moja iliyopotea, mpaka aipate. What am I saying? I'm saying these people, children of God, that God has given unto us, that whatever is given unto us is not in his church. Hallelujah. Though God has called us to occupy, to rule and to dominate as his church, whatever he has given unto us, that we may use it to rule and to dominate until he comes, it is not in the church.
Hallelujah.
Mama alipopoteza peni yake akiwa nyumbani. I know there is a different fashion of interpretation of the same verse. But what I'm trying to see is mama alipopoteza hela zake akiwa nyumbani wala sio kanisani, akaamua hiyo siku afadhali kwanza aitafute mpaka aipate, kwa sababu kile ambacho Mungu ametupa hakiko katika nyumba zake bali ziko katika nyumba zetu. Tumejawa na ubinafsi kwamba tunaletea Mungu kile ambacho kimebaki lakini sio kile ambacho ametupa. Hallelujah. We bring unto God what has been left over, but not what is the right thing. Hallelujah. Whatever God has provided unto us, that we may be the rulers of His kingdom, it is not in His house. And somebody can bear me witness with this. Because many are the times when the church has been looked down upon. The church has not been given its rightful position. Because we are only looked like people who can only provide prayer guidelines. Watu wanapohitaji msaada kutoka kwetu kama kanisa, wanatuona kwamba kile ambacho tunaweza tukakuwapatia ni maombi peke yake. Japo kuwa Mungu hajatupa maombi peke yake, Mungu ametupa uwezo wa fedha, Mungu ametupa maoni mazuri, Mungu ametupa uongozi mzuri, Mungu ametupa vitu zuri, lakini what people look at to us is that we can only give an offering of prayer. Hallelujah. We have forgotten our position as child. We have forgotten our position as people of God. We don't know what we are supposed to offer. We don't know what we are supposed to do. We only feel that we can only give that what has been left over. And we have accepted the position. I don't know whether somebody understands what I'm saying. I hope somebody gets what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, we have been called to occupy until when He comes back. And Jesus, when He was demonstrating this, the Bible says from where we have read that He gave minas to His servant. Somebody gave minas to His servant and He told them, do this business until when I am back. And these people needed to understand that whatever it is that they have been given by call, that they have been called to take charge of whatever they have been given. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. And when God was creating mankind in the Garden of Eden, the Bible says that He gave him dominion over every creation of the world. That He gave him dominion over everything that was in that land. That He gave him dominion over the birds of the air. He gave him dominion over anything in that land. But then man did not understand his position in the Garden of Eden. That's why one time, when God came to visit Adam in the Garden of Eden, God did not find Adam where he was supposed to be because Adam had lost control and dominion. Adam was not found in his position. He was found outside his position. He had already started losing his dominion. He has already started not to occupy until God came. Hallelujah. God comes back to see what Adam is doing, only to find Adam is not where he's supposed to be. Only to find that Adam is not occupying. Only to find that Adam is not in charge. Only to find Adam is not dominating. And this is what most of us are doing nowadays. That we have lost dominion. That we have lost control. That we don't know what we stand for. That we don't know that we have power and authority. That we don't know that we have been called to be priests and the kings of the Most High. That we don't understand that in the position of call, we have been kept here that we may take charge of whatever God has given unto us. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. People, children of God, I want you to understand that God does not operate in isolation. That God cannot operate alone. God requires mankind that he may operate through mankind. God requires man that he may manifest through man. God requires you that he may use you to manifest himself. Don't know whether somebody understands me. When God wanted to deliver the children of Israel from the bondage of captivity, God had to use Moses, because God uses and works through men. He had to manifest through Moses. When God wanted to deal with the gods of Baal, he had to use Elijah, because he could not come unto himself. He had to manifest through his servant. Hallelujah. When God wanted to bring revival and revelation to his church, he had to use his apostles. Hallelujah. God operates through man. God operates through mankind. God wants to operate through you. It is only through you that the good works of the Lord can be manifested. Don't know whether you understand this. That it is through you that God can manifest himself. And therefore you must be ready for God to manifest through you. Because he can only use a vessel which is ready to be used by him. Hallelujah. Mungu hawezi akafanya kazi peke yake pasipo mwanadamu. Kwa hivyo inahitaji mwanadamu ambaye yuko tayari kutumiwa na Mungu ndio matendo na kazi ya Mungu ionekane katika maisha ya watu wake. And I'm calling you this day to ask, are you ready to be used as vessels of honor? Are you ready to occupy that God may use you as his vessel? Are you ready for God to manifest through you? Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Are we ready to occupy in the position so that God can use us and manifest through him? Hallelujah. Is somebody ready? Are we ready really as church? Hallelujah. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Nataka tujielewe, tuache kujiweka chini. Nataka tujifahamu kwamba pasipo sisi, pasipo kanisa, ni kwamba itakuwa gumu sana Mungu kudhihirisha matendo yake. Na inatupasa tuamuke na tukubali kwamba ni kupitia kwangu na wewe ndiposa Mungu ataweza kufanya kazi. Hallelujah. Occupy till he comes. People and children of God, the Bible says in the book of Matthew, chapter number 28, 18 to 20, that all the power and authority in heaven and on earth have been given to us, that we may go forth to make disciples. And Jesus is promising that he will be with us until the end of the world. Hallelujah. Jesus is speaking unto his disciples, and he is telling them, every other power that belongs to the heaven and unto the world has been given unto me. And therefore, Jesus, as Son of God, I'm going to delegate that power unto you as my disciples. Just go forth, go ye, and make disciples for this kingdom. And I'm going to be with you until the end of this world. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. What is Jesus saying? That no matter what, no matter the situation, no matter the instance, no matter the coincidence, that he is going to be with you. Every step of the life that you are going to walk, everything that you are going to do, every move that you are going to make, that he is going to be with you. He is going to walk with you. He is going to encourage you. He is going to empower you. He is going to provide for you. And then until the end of the world, he is not going to leave you, neither forsake you. Hallelujah. God has delegated his power, his authority unto us as his church, that we may go forth and do what we have been called to do as sons and daughters of the kingdom. And as we do so, he is not going to leave us, neither forsake us. Hallelujah. He will be with us until the end of the world. That's what he says. And if he is promising that he is going to be with us until the end of the world, it is a sure bet. It is an assurance that you are not going to lose, that you are not going to wear away, that you are not going to get frustrated, that you are not going to be alone. He will be with you until the end of the world. Amen. Hallelujah. We are being called to occupy until he comes back. People and children of God, if I understand very well what the Bible is telling me, is that as children, as sons and daughters of the kingdom, whatever it is that we have been called to do as church, if it is in the line and in the plan of God, we are going to reign in power and authority. We are going to arise. We are going to decree a thing, as our brothers say, and it is going to get established. We are going to chase away the evil demons, and they are going to run away. We are going to get out those who have been bedridden. They are going to stand. We are going to lift those who have been put down by the enemy, and they, by the power and authority that we are going to release, that they are going to walk again. Wherever we go, we are supposed to dominate. Wherever we go, people are supposed to hear our influence. Wherever we stand, people are supposed to recognize our presence. Wherever we are, the power of God is supposed to be felt. Hallelujah.
We cannot be called to occupy until he comes. But wherever we call, we cannot influence people positively. That wherever we walk, people cannot understand that we are born again. That whenever we don't walk with the power and dominion. We have been called to occupy until he comes. Not unless he has come back, we should stand in the position. And nations should understand that we have been called for the sake of the kingdom in this world. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. I don't know you people whether you have the courage of the salvation that God has given unto you. I don't understand whether you people, you feel the power and the dominion that God has given unto you. I don't know whether you people, you exercise whatever it is that God has given unto you. Because he has promised that he's going to be with you until the end of the day. I call upon my brothers and sisters that we should arise and let people understand who we are in this world. Let people understand who we are in the political arenas. Let people understand what our positions are in the economic field. Let people understand what we are in the social life. Hallelujah. If you are born again and you cannot influence somebody by your ways of living, somebody cannot testify that this is a born again brother. If by your way of doing things does not reflect and manifest the good doings of the Lord, then you need to reevaluate and recheck yourself. Something is wrong, because it means that you have lost your position to occupy and to rule. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. How many times that decisions which affect us as Christians have been made and the church has remained silent, not to do or say anything, because we have lost the position of occupying until he comes. Poor and evil decisions have been made in our place of work. Poor and evil decisions have been made in our families. Poor and evil decisions have been made in our places where we stay. But we have not taken our position to rule and to say that this is not the right decision, and that the position of God in this case should be this and this and this. Hallelujah. You know, people and children of God, sometimes you better talk and people not listen to you instead of keeping quiet. Mara nyingi tumeokwa chini. Watu wametudharau, wametukosea heshima, kwa sababu kile ambacho wanasema ndicho ambacho tunakubali. Na hata hatutaki kutoa maoni yetu. Na hata hatukitoa maoni yetu ni kwamba saa nyingine hawaiamini, kwa sababu hawaoni Mungu ndani yako. Hallelujah. Are we really occupying? Are we really taking charge? Are we really doing this business until he comes? Hallelujah. I want somebody to arise today. I want somebody to take charge today. I want somebody to stand today and declare that wherever I stand, that wherever I am, at any particular time, people are going to appreciate that I carry a powerful call. That whatever I speak, I'll speak it with power and authority. That people will understand that it is not me who is speaking, but God who is in me. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. We cannot sit down and watch things go wrong while we have been given power and authority. While we have been called to occupy, while we have been called to rule, we should not just sit down and watch things go wrong. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. We serve a very big kingdom. We serve a living God. We serve a mighty God. We serve an everlasting Father. We serve the one who says that he will never leave us, never forsake us. He is never going to let you be ashamed. He cannot allow people to pull you down and to frustrate you beyond what you can be able to do. At whatever point and cost, he is going to arise on your behalf and he is going to manifest on your behalf. Hallelujah. As people, sons, daughters of the kingdom, let us occupy until he comes. Hallelujah. Let us occupy even the environment where we stay. Let us occupy the atmosphere where we are. Let us occupy the neighborhood where we dwell. Let us occupy our places of work. Let us occupy any other position that has been given unto us. Let us take charge and occupy. And when you occupy, you declare things as they get to happen. When you occupy, you declare even and you speak unto atmosphere and it hears what you are saying. You declare something unto the environment and it hears what you are saying. Because it has ears. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. It is the power that we have been given. The power that we have been given. Hallelujah. To occupy until he comes. And if God has paid every cost, if Jesus paid for every cost, if the Good Samaritan paid for every cost that was supposed to be used for the person who was hurt until he comes back, I want to understand as the church of God is that God has paid for every cost. God has provided for every resources. God has provided for every finances. God has given us every strength. God has given us every ability that is required for us to rule and occupy until when he's back. Hallelujah. The Good Samaritan paid for everything. And he has not come back to pay for anything. If it was therefore used, I also want to believe that our master has paid for every cost, has provided for anything that we need, has given us what we need in this life, has provided the church with anything that it needs, has provided unto his sons and daughters of what they want. And until he is back, you are not supposed to run empty. You are not supposed to lack anything until he comes. When he left, he paid for everything. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. When Jesus was leaving this world, he paid for everything that you require. He paid for all your expenses. He paid for all your medical bills. He paid for all your necessities. He paid for anything that you needed. And until that he has come back, your bills have been fully footed. Hallelujah. Until he comes back, you are assured that all is well. Hallelujah. And we have not seen him come because we still have our young brothers and sisters here who are not yet married. He cannot come until they marry and have families. Hallelujah. Atakaka mpaka pia na waishi maisha mazuri. Hallelujah. Therefore, children, people, of God. Let it be an awakening call to all of us that we have been called, given the position. And apart from being given the position, we have been provided with the resources. We have been given the power. We have been provided with the authority. We have been provided with every resources that is required for us as church, as people and children of God, that we may take charge until he comes back. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of the living God, my Savior, my Redeemer, the one King of glory, who calls us by our name, who understands the numbers of the hairs in our head, King of glory, dear Master, thank you for everything, my Father, that you have done unto us, King of glory. Thank you for the word of today. Thank you for the revelation of your word, my Master. Thank you for speaking unto us, King of glory. Thank you for coming through for us, dear Lord. Thank you, Master, and our Savior, because we have understood our position as church, Master and King of glory. We are going to rule. We are going to reign. We are going to take charge. We are going to occupy. We are going to do your business until you come back. Until you come back, my dear Lord, we are not going to run away. We are not going to lack anything. We are not going, my Father, to be frustrated, dear Lord. My Father, King of glory, and I speak from this altar, dear Lord, and I declare in this altar, my Father, that whatever, King of glory, you have called us to do, that, dear Lord, you are going to enable us, King of glory. You are going to provide unto us, my Father. You are going to come through for us, my Master. You are going to manifest, King of glory, in the name of the living God. Thank you, Jehovah, because this month, my Father, it is a month of restoration. Whatever it is, King of glory, that was stolen from us, dear Lord, and that we are not in a position to occupy, King of glory, may you restore unto your people. May you restore unto your church. May you restore unto your nation. May you restore, O King of glory, in the name of the living God. Let your people, my Master, be partakers of your blessing. Let your people, King of glory, glorify your mighty name. Let your people, my Master, speak of your good deeds upon their life, in the name of the living God. Loving Father, King of glory, I stand in this altar, my Master, and I declare, King of glory, the doors which were closed by the enemy, that you are going to open them afresh, my dear Lord. In the name of the living God, Mtakatifu na Jehovah, ulifungua milango kwa ajili ya wana wako, wakati ambapo mfalme, malango yalifunguka, yule shetani mwovu, akakuja akaifunga, wakati ambapo ilifungwa, watoto wako Jehovah, wakapoteza mamlaka, kwa siku ya leo Jehovah, naomba kwamba mfalme, ukafanye urejesho kwa ajili yao katika jina la Yesu Kristo, ukarejeshe heshima kwa ajili yao, ukarejeshe hadhi kwa ajili yao, ukarejeshe matumaini kwa ajili yao, ukarejeshe fedha zao Bwana, ukarejeshe matumaini kwa Bwana, ukarejeshe afya yao Bwana katika jina la Yesu Kristo, diposa wakatawale ufalme katika uwezo na mamlaka katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Na wacha mbingu siku ya leo isikae kimya Bwana, kwa ajili ya hawa mfalme uliowaleta katika nyumba yako, katika jina la Yesu Kristo. He mtakatifu na Bwana, wengine wamedharauliwa Jehova katika sehemu zao za kazi, wacha mtakatifu na Bwana ukarejeshe mamlaka kwao, wakatawale Bwana wanaponena Jehova Jehova, sauti zao zikasikike, wengine mtakatifu na Bwana, katika jamii zao, hawana heshima, hawana thamana, lakini kwa siku ya leo, wameitanishwa na jina lako, ukarejeshe heshima kwao, sauti zao zikashimike, katika jina la Yesu Kristo, mtakatifu na Bwana, wengine wetu Bwana, ni kwamba ulitenga nyota kwa ajili yetu, lakini shetani akaziba, kwa siku leo famu na Bwana, tunadharauliwa Jehova, wacha ukafanye urejesho wa nyota zetu, katika jina la Yesu Kristo, kila mmoja famu na Mungu wetu, aliofika katika ibada ya siku leo, wacha ukamuonewe mabwana, ukamtendee haki Jehova, wacha ukamsimamishe Jehova, katika nafasi yake mamlaka, katika jina la Yesu Kristo, tukafanye kile ambacho tunastahili, Bwana Mungu wetu, mpaka utakaporejea, utupate katika nafasi zetu, katika jina la Yesu Kristo, nakataa ufahamu na Bwana, kuondolewa katika kiti cha mamlaka, nakataa ufahamu na Bwana, kudharauliwa tena Jehova, nakataa tena Bwana, kusema sema yasiyo ya kweli Bwana, kwa uwezo wako Jehova, wacha ukarejeshe heshima, kwa ajili ya kanisa lako, wacha ukarejeshe heshima kwa ajili ya watumishi wako, ukarejeshe heshima kwa ajili ya watoto wako, ukarejeshe heshima kwa ajili ya taifa lako, ukarejeshe heshima kwa ajili ya kusanyiko lako, ukarejeshe heshima kwa wanaoitanishwa nawe Bwana, isiwe dharau tena Bwana, unawarejesha katika nafasi yao ya kutawala, na wacha ikajulikane hata na taifa, ni kwamba wewe Bwana ndiwe ambao ulitenda, na hakuna ambaye anaweza akabadilisha wala kubatilisha uamuzi wako. Tunalisifu jina lako na kunatukuza Jehova, pokea sifa na heshima, ukuka wewe famu na Bwana, mwenye mamlaka na uwezo, jidhihirishe, jionyeshe, tamalaki ufalme kwa ajili ya maisha wana wako, wacha ikawa ni siku ya tofauti tunapoondoka katika madhabahu. Mungu wetu, unajua ni wapi ambapo tulipoteza nafasi, unajua ni wapi tulipoteza katika njia zetu, unajua ni wapi ambapo tulikosea. Tunaomba kwa heshima ukafanya urejesho, tukaweze kutawala, tukawaze kutamalaki, tukakae katika nafasi ambapo tunastahili, katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Hakuna mmoja wetu Bwana ambaye amenyimwa haki kwa ajili ya kutawala. Kwa siku ya leo Bwana, turehemu, tuonekanie na utufanyie wema, kwa jina la Yesu Kristo tunaomba kwa kuamini, tuaseme amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Naomba tunapoondoka kwa ibada ya siku na wakati huu, tukajua kwamba we have been called to occupy, to take charge, dominate, be responsible and do what we have been called to do until he comes back. Don't lose your position. Don't lose your authority. Don't lose what you have been given. Amen. 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 Before we leave or we share the grace, I want to recognize our dear mom, the pastor of our pastor. Thank you for being with us. We recognize you. We appreciate you. Thank you for being our mother. We are really happy. Thank you for our chairman for making it with us. We really appreciate. Thank you for our leaders who have made unto this service. We really appreciate you equally. Thank you. Na wewe pia ambao ulifika kwa ibada ya siku ya leo, tunakushukuru sana.
unakaa vizuri. Hallelujah. Unakaa vizuri. Naona unapendeza. Amen. Kabla tuondoke, kama tuko na wageni miongoni mwetu, kwa ishara ya mkono tu, tungetaka kutambua uwepo wako. By show of hand, thank you. Let us appreciate our visitors. We are really grateful. We are happy to have you. We'd like to welcome you once again and again in this altar of BMI. Stay blessed, stay blessed, stay blessed. Let us stand and share the grace. Surely, goodness, mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. May the grace, Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Let us meet on Tuesday kutoka saa 12 ya jioni. Na kabla pia tuondoke, niliombwa na kiongozi wa wamama kwamba angeomba na angetaka kuwa na usemi nanyi kidogo. Kwa hivyo kama wewe ni mama, kama wewe ni mama, kwa heshima ya hali ya juu sana, umeombwa na kiongozi wako ubaki asemezane nawe. Asanteni sana. Thank you.